Let's take up some important points regarding mechanism of addition of halogens to alkynes. First step is heterolytic fission of Br2. The heterolytic fission will lead to Br positive and Br negative. This pair of electron, that is one bond will break, so pi electron will shift to this carbon, and this Br positive will attack this carbon and you will get CHBr. Triple bond has changed to double bond, here positive charge will be formed because pair of electron has shifted to this carbon. Now this positively charged carbocation will react with negatively charged ion, and this will Br will get attached to this carbon and will result in the formation of unsaturated dibromo compound. This is first step of the addition. The fact that dibromo alkene formed at the first stage is trans. It means that two Br are attacking from the opposite side, and it also shows the cationic intermediate formed in this step of the reaction has cyclic structure. This is the cyclic structure of intermediate carbocation, and this will attack with the Br negative. Now this side already there is crowding, so Br will attack from the opposite side and result in the formation of trans dibromo alkene. Trans means that Br groups are on opposite side. In second step, we have dibromo compound and Br positive, that is electrophile, which is already generated. This will attack to this carbon because this pi electron will shift to this carbon, and here it has attacked and it has become CHBr2. This carbon will become positively charged because pair of electron has already shifted to this carbon. So this is carbocation formed, which will react with now Br negative and will get attached to this carbon. We get tetrabromo compound, which is final addition compound, and this is second step of the reaction. Next we are taking addition of hydrogen halide. This reaction is catalyzed by light or mercury salt, and in the case of unsymmetrical alkynes, addition of HX, that is hydrogen halide, takes place according to Markovnikov's rule, which was also applicable in unsymmetrical alkenes. So unsymmetrical alkenes and alkynes both follow Markovnikov's rule for addition of polar compound. For example, this is symmetrical alkyne, which is reacting with HX. So X has been added to this carbon, H has been added to this carbon. In the second step, again H positive will be added to this carbon and X will be added to this carbon. We get this compound. This is symmetrical, so X can be added either to this carbon and hydrogen to this, or hydrogen can be added to this carbon and X to this carbon, same product will be formed. So in symmetrical alkenes, Markovnikov rule is not applicable. Mechanism of this reaction can be outlined like this. The first, this HX undergoes heterolytic fission, and this H positive ion will get attracted towards pi electrons and form this cyclic carbonium ion intermediate, which reacts with X negative from the opposite side. So H gets attached here, whereas X gets attached from the opposite side, and we get transform. In the next step, HX again gets added. One H will be added here, it becomes RCH2, and X will be added to the same carbon here, so we get dihalogen compound, which has been added to the symmetrical alkyne. Next, we are taking addition of hypohalous acid. This addition takes place in two steps to form dihalocarbonyl compound, as shown below. This is again symmetrical alkynes. In hypochlorous acid, it undergoes heterolytic fission. OH becomes negative, Cl becomes positive. Why OH becomes negative? Because oxygen is more electronegative than Cl. Now this OH negative will attack this carbon, and Cl positive will attack this carbon, and triple bond will change to double bond. This is the first step of addition reaction. And this reaction will start with electrophile, that is positive will attack first and then negative will attack. In the second step, HOCl we are again adding. HOCl will break into OH negative and Cl positive. Cl positive will attack to the same carbon where it has attacked earlier. So we get 2Cl here, and OH will also attack to the same carbon where it has attacked earlier. Now remember, two OH at same carbon are unstable. So this OH and this H will leave water. Water will be removed, And when H positive from here and OH negative from here goes, here double bond will be formed. This is the double bond form. So we have got dichloroketone, which is the final product in this reaction. Next, we are taking nucleophilic addition reactions. As we have seen that the carbon-carbon triple bond has a reduced reactivity towards electrophilic reagent because the carbon is sp hybridized and it holds the pi electrons tightly. Therefore, it is reasonable argument that the carbon-carbon triple bond should be susceptible to nucleophile attack. That is, it should undergo nucleophile attack more readily. The nucleophilic addition reactions are catalyzed by heavy metal ions, and these metal ions form a sort of complex with alkynes. This is the triple bond. We are reacting with mercuric ions, and this is the intermediate complex which is formed. The formation of this complex lowers the electron density around the triple bond, and this provides the path for the nucleophilic reagent. Some of the examples of this type of reactions, addition reactions, are given below. First, we are taking addition of water. This reaction is catalyzed by mercuric sulfate and dilute sulfuric acid. This we have a terminal alkynes which reacts with water in the presence of HgSO4 and H2SO4. Water breaks down into HN and OHN in the presence of sulfuric acid. OHN will attack to the middle carbon. According to Markovnikov's rule, H will be added to the terminal carbon, and this we get intermediate. This is called enol form. Double bond and OH group, we call it enol form. This will rearrange. How it rearranges? This H shifts here, this H shifts here, and this double bond shifts here. So we get keto group here, and here becomes CH3. This is called keto form. Enol form, keto form, this is also called keto enol tautomerism. That is shifting of H positive ion from one atom to another and shifting of double bond simultaneously is called keto enol tautomerism. So keto form is more stable than enol form. That's why the enol form changes to keto form. Reaction proceeds via following mechanism. In the first step, mercuric ion will add and form an unstable intermediate. This will be attacked by water, and here Hg plus 2 will change to Hd plus 1, and here water has attached to this carbon. It will acquire positive charge because the lone pair of electron on oxygen has been donated to this carbon. This OH positive charge on oxygen being unstable, it will lose H positive ion, and here OH ion will form the bond. Here Hg plus is still there, this double bond is still there. Now we react with H positive ion, which will replace Hg plus. So Hg plus will be out, and here we will get H. This is called enol form. So how it changes to ketone form? This H shifts here, and this double bond shifts here. We get keto form. This is keto enol tautomerism. Let's take up example. Acetylene, when reacts with water in the presence of sulfuric acid and H2SO4, it results in the formation of acetylide. Here also, first enol form will be formed, ultimately acetaldehyde will be formed. Or in other way, you can add water first and then again add water and remove water from the carbon which has two OH group. This product will be formed. So both the methods you can use, whatever you are comfortable, you can use it. Either change enol form to keto form, that's much easier. If you find it difficult, then add water twice and remove water from two OH groups. You will get aldehyde. Same reaction takes place, similar reaction takes place here, but this takes place according to Markovnikov's rule. We add water in the presence of mercuric sulfate and H2SO4, OH will attach to middle carbon and H will attach to terminal carbon, this carbon. Then another water, if you add, one more OH will be attached to middle carbon and one more H will be added to the terminal carbon. This OH and this OH will lose water molecule, result in the formation of keto group, acetone is formed. Another way is the enol form which you get rearranged to form keto, as we have discussed earlier.